Let's talk about one Dallas Cowboys, Jerry Jones. He was asked about CeeDee Lamb's contract. His comments was, "I don't have any urgency to get it done," to which CeeDee Lamb went on X and tweeted, LOL. Now, of course, CeeDee Lamb hasn't participating in training camp. He's obviously holding out for his contract. I'm reading it right here from an article from Sports Illustrated's Carl Rasmussen. Says it right here. Hope I'm pronouncing that right. As it stands, Lamb is due to earn $17.991 million under the fifth-year option of his rookie deal. He's been holding out of training camp as he angles to receive a contract extension in Dallas, though it doesn't seem Jones is going to be so swayed. Lamb will surely be looking to be compensated as one of the highest-paid wide receivers in football and could reasonably seek north of $30 million per year. The Cowboys are also holding off on paying quarterback Dak Prescott, who, like Lamb, will be a free agent after the 2024 season. So, Champ, and we got a comment right here from RJD. Hola, amigos. Appreciate it, dude. Champ. Cowboys, they got to make some serious decisions because CeeDee's contract, as I mentioned, Dak will be a free agent next season, and you got to take care of Micah Parsons. So I think for Jerry, and this, of course, is casual as usual. We all know casual. But, Champ, let me ask you this question. Jerry's got to make a serious decision. He could say, "Hey, I don't have any urgency to pay him, but you better, because how are you going to find another wide receiver in the draft or something to replace CeeDee Lamb? Plus, you're not going to lose Michael Parsons. I think you're going to have to move on from Dak Prescott. I would like to see Dak Prescott go somewhere else. Question is where? Maybe Pittsburgh or any type of team that's in contention to compete. I would like to see Dak Prescott go elsewhere because I've seen enough with Dak Prescott in Dallas. This is as far as he can go. And plus, Jerry doesn't want to pay him that amount of money. So I don't see that happening. Now, if it were Tony Romo, on the other hand, that's a different story. But I think he's going to have to move on from Dak Prescott. You're going to have to pay CeeDee his money. And heck, who knows? You mentioned Joe Milton. Maybe he could consider getting another quarterback because we haven't. I'm sorry, Chip, but Trey Lance just ain't it. And he hasn't been it. And, you know, I try to remain hopeful on Trey Lance, but it doesn't seem like he's the guy for them going forward. So if you're Jerry, if you're Dallas, I suggest you move on from Dak. Keep CeeDee, keep Micah. And then probably get somebody else, whether in a trade or in the draft. If I were Dallas, and plus, you got a really good quarterback class in next year. What do you think?
Hey, in the great words of my grandfather, don't nothing come to a sleeper but a dream. And I believe that's what Trey Lance is, a sleeper. And I think it's a dream for us to think that he's any good. Number one, it was a reach in order for the 49ers to go get him number four in the first place. That's number one. He was already in a win now situation up there in San Francisco. And when you have to ask yourself, if Kyle Shanahan can't get you to where you need to be, it's kind of time to start asking yourself, do I need to consider another profession? Kyle Shanahan made it to a Super Bowl with Jimmy Garoppolo. Let me say that again. He made it to a Super Bowl with Jimmy Garoppolo. He's had no Hall of Famers other than Matt Ryan as his quarterback. You saw what he did the first time he had a Hall of Famer.
Right.
He's made it to the playoffs with RG3. He's made it to the playoffs with Kirk Cousins. He's made it to the playoffs with Matt Ryan. So there's been a plethora of quarterbacks.
And Brock Purdy.
Yes, and Roethlisberger.
Brock Purdy, excuse me.
My bad. I don't know why I said Roethlisberger. My bad. My bad to the audience. My fault. But He hasn't had but one Hall of Fame quarterback to speak of. One. That was Matty Ice. And you saw what he did when he had him for just 2 years. People don't realize he wasn't with Matt Ryan for more than 2 years. First year, he went 8-8. The second year, Super Bowl MVP. So when Kyle Shanahan gives up on you, it's kind of time for you to just say, like, wait a minute. Did we draft him too high? Was it a mistake? Because he really did play a lot in college. People say, well, he didn't get a fair shot. He really didn't play a lot in college. It was a reach to get him in with the number four overall pick. Third. I think they should take a shot at a Joe Mixon, you know, depending on if they can get him for a third or a fourth round pick, depending on how the Patriots develop him. With CD, as far as CD Lamb goes, we've seen these antics before with Jerry Jones. Remember the Zeke Who t-shirts? And he was joking around with him. It was just, it's theater in Dallas. You can't read too much into it. It's always theater. I got to keep the show going to let us remain relevant so that when we start losing, the show's still here. And this is just another ploy. This is why they're saying that they're not urgent. You need to be. This is a receiver that just won, that nearly won a triple crown last year.
Right.
So, I mean, and without CeeDee Lamb, you've had Brandon Cooks, who's a serviceable wide receiver, but not necessarily a world beater. And you have a plethora of other wide receivers who hasn't surpassed so much as 500 yards in a season. So, hey, you might want to go ahead and get that done, you know, because, hey, there's a lot of teams around this league that'll be happy to pay a CeeDee Lamb next year. And they'll give him anything he asked for. So the thing is, you might want to be urgent in signing your wide receiver, your number one receiver, and your number one linebacker, which I will put him right up there with Derek Thomas as being one of the greatest pass rushers I've ever seen. And in Micah Parsons. Can never pronounce his name correctly. But you might want to sign those two and leave Dak where he is and leave well enough alone. Sometimes as a CEO of an organization, you have to realize when something is not working. You have to realize it. San Francisco realized that with Jimmy Garoppolo. That's why they tried to go get Trey Lance. When he didn't work out, God bless them in order to be able to have a Brock Purdy. You saw what the St. Louis Rams did. Well, excuse me, the Los Angeles Rams now, what they did with Jared Goff. They didn't think that he could lead them far. So guess what? They went and said, you know what? You got us to the Super Bowl. We can't win with you. Come to find out, they was right. They went and got that Georgia Bulldog away from Detroit. Guess what? The rest is history.
Mm-hmm.
So there's been evidence of guys, of teams, and organizations saying this is not working. They get rid of that quarterback that everybody's trying to hold on so tightly for nowadays, which I don't understand. It's just like football is a game of chess. Stop playing every piece like every piece hurts, especially the quarterback. Because the thing is, we've seen so many quarterbacks win with great teams around them and win Super Bowls. You ain't necessarily have to have a world beater, but the thing is, when you realize that this is not working, it's not working.
Mm-hmm.
It's not working. So the best thing that Jerry Jones and that organization can do is get CeeDee Lamb signed, get Micah Parsons signed, and hey, if you want $70 million, you want that NBA type of salary of a contract, and you haven't gotten us so much as to an NFC championship, I suggest you go elsewhere because you're not going to get it in Dallas. You've been in the league almost 9 years. You've had a plethora of talent come through Dallas. Say what you want to about Jerry Jones, and that Dallas organization is all theater, but it's been a replenishment of talent. A replenishment constantly. So guess what? It's not like you've been without talent. It's not like you've been without great wide receivers, great offensive linemen, great defenses. It's not like you've been without that. And each time you have failed. 5 out of the 9 years that Dak has been there, his defense and offense has not been outside of the top 10.
Right.
So you put, and if you get any other quarterback there, we will be calling it out every single year. Because that's what we talk about with other teams. That's what we talk about with other quarterbacks. He didn't have a good defense. He didn't have a good offense. He didn't have enough weapons. Okay, 5 out of the 9 years that you've been in the league, your offense and your defense has been no less than in the top 10. 1 year, it fell out of the top. 1 year, your defense fell to the top 11.
Right.
So it's time for you to perform, and I don't think he's it. I mean, everybody wants to hold tightly to their quarterbacks nowadays. I think that's a mistake, but especially considering how much these quarterbacks are being paid based off potential alone. Potential. So, and when you haven't shown much promise of that potential, guess what? It's time for you to move on. Sign CeeDee Lamb, sign Parsons, hey, and go get you another quarterback. You got a hell of a quarterback class coming out, and you got some hidden gems in this league. If you're going to pay somebody off potential, hell, go get you a quarterback, kind of like what Jacksonville did with Mark Brunell, kind of like what St. Louis did with Kurt Warner. There's some hidden gems out there that can get you to a Super Bowl. We've seen it one too many times.
To me, Champ, it seems like they're just paying. They just want to hold on to Dak Prescott because they feel like, well, if we lose him, where else can we find someone that's better? You know, we've had Flash and we've had BRF had this discussion. They would move on from CD because they feel like wide receiver, they can get wide receivers just like that. And plus, can you get our elite wide receivers are going to win you a championship? No, you're not gonna. No, you're gonna need a quarterback in order for you to deliver the goods. But we've seen Dak Prescott now. This is now his 9th year. This is the final year of his 4-year extension that he signed in 2021. And we've seen Dak good, but just not great. This is as far as he can go. I believe if you put Dak Prescott in different circumstances. Let's say if you put him in the Pittsburgh Steelers, Champ, I really do think they have a good enough chance. Mike Tomlin, to this day, still has not had a losing record under his watch. And plus, Russ and Justin Fields are there, but it's only temporarily. You put him with a good enough defense. You put him with some playmakers. Why not Dak, okay? Let's see Dak in different circumstances. Champ, honestly, if Atlanta didn't pay Kirk Cousins or Michael Penix, I wouldn't mind him going to Atlanta. Although you may not like it. Mm-mm. But why?
To be honest with you, if you really look at the Steelers and the weapons that they have right now, what is the biggest difference between the weapons that he has in Dallas last couple of years and Pittsburgh? The only difference is you don't have a TJ Watt. That's the only difference. You have receivers. You have running backs. They're offering you the same thing. And another thing is, guess what? You might be in an even worse situation when you go to Pittsburgh. They've had 6 offensive coordinators over the past 7 years. And guess what? They just hired my old head coach. And Arthur Smith, how do you think that's going to work out this year with Justin Fields and Russell Wilson, considering what he just did down there in Atlanta?
I know, Champ, but here's the thing. Would you rather him in Pittsburgh or would you rather still want him in Dallas in Mike McCarthy? I've said it before, Champ, you're not going to win a championship with Jerry Jones. Doesn't matter who you have at quarterback. It doesn't matter the talent. Jerry Jones will get in the way. And look, Mike McCarthy, I've said what I've said before about him, man. There's nothing about him, like, from a leadership standpoint. There have been issues with his clock management. Now, I will give him credit as far as him doing a better job with the play calling since he took over for Kellen Moore. But there is no chance in hell you winning a Super Bowl under these circumstances with the Dallas Cowboys. And they brought back Ezekiel Elliott. But, okay, you should have gotten Blake Corum, the running back from Michigan. Unfortunately for Dallas, he's with the Los Angeles Rams, and now he's paired up with Kieran Williams. And the Rams, I wouldn't sleep on the Rams. They could actually be a team to consider in the NFC, even though they've lost Aaron Donald. Aaron Donald has retired. But when I look at Dak, champ, if not Pittsburgh, where else could you see him going? Because 49ers, are they going to pay Brock Purdy? Jets, we know with the situation with Aaron Rodgers, where you want him to go to? You want him to go to Vegas?
I wouldn't mind him going to Vegas, to be honest with you. I mean, they don't have a quarterback situation. I mean, you know, Devontae Adams, he needs some solid quarterback play on his side of the ball. I mean, I wouldn't mind that happening. My thing is this. You put him in Pittsburgh, that's the same situation that he's in Dallas right now. You have a number one receiver. You've had number one receivers. You had great running backs. You had great defenses. It's the same situation. Now, granted, I will give you credit on this. The main thing that you have not had in Dallas is a coach that's going to light a fire up on you. And I think Mike Tomlin, to your credit, can do that with Dak. So I wouldn't mind him seeing him. My thing is, it's the same situation. It's the same set of circumstances. You have a dual back system like you had last year with Zeke and Tony Pollard. Now you go into another one with Tyrone and Najee Harris. Depending on if they get Brandon Ayuk, you have a George Pickens and a Brandon Ayuk. Then you have that monster on the other side of the ball and TJ Watt and that defense. So, hey, it's the same circumstances you're in already. Now, like I said, to your credit, what you're saying, the major difference is a coach is going to light a fire up on you, because I don't think Mike McCarthy likes that spark like a Mike Tomlin would.
The owners I mentioned about that, you ain't winning with Jerry Jones running the show. Mm-hmm. That's another problem that I have with Dallas. And people talk about sacrifice, the players, they got to sacrifice. Well, damn, what about Jerry? Jerry wants credit, and he wants to run the show. He's doing interviews. He has his own radio show and stuff like that. The problem is Jerry Jones is too involved with the Dallas Cowboys, which is why, champ, after when they lost that playoff game to the Green Bay Packers last season, are they going to hire Bill Belichick? Are they going to hire Jim Harbaugh? I was like, ain't no way in hell that going to happen. Because at the end of the day, Jerry running the show. Do you really think Jerry Jones is going to sit back and allow people to do their job? Knowing how much money he makes, knowing how much authority that he has? Nah. So to me, and plus, champ, we mentioned this before. Jerry tried to draft Johnny Manziel back in 2014. But fortunately, Stephen Jones talked him out of it and said, no, we going with Zach Martin, who's going to the Pro Football Hall of Fame eventually. So I'm sorry, champ. I mean, okay, Pittsburgh, I understand Arthur Smith. He was horrible as an offensive coordinator. No one would know that better than you. And you were done with him. Even after that season finale game last year against the New Orleans Saints. Matter of fact, you were probably done with him in that road game against the Carolina Panthers when y'all could barely score. I don't even know if y'all scored a touchdown in that game.
The defense held the Carolina Panthers to 9 points. 9 points in the Monsoon Bowl, I call it. We held Bryce Young to 9 points and still lost that game. Now, you name me one defense. You got held to 9 points, 3 field goals. And you could not generate a touchdown and a field goal in order to beat a rookie quarterback on a team that is as dysfunctional as any team I have ever seen in the Carolina Panthers last year, I would say. So that's when I was done with Arthur Smith. Plus, I mean,
Desmond Ridder. What have you said about Desmond Ridder?
He couldn't pass gas if you fed him beans all night long. So the thing is, you didn't have to be so heavily reliant on the quarterback. You had two beasts at the running back position. Use them. You underutilized Bijan Robinson. You underutilized Tyler Aguilar. How many pieces can you get handed and just say, hey, I can't. you was handed a lot of pieces on a silver platter. And when you saw it wasn't working with Desmond Ridder, you saw he was a turnover machine. Why did you turn back to him? I understand the injury, but good God, why did you turn back to him and keep trying to turn back to him? You should have kept Heinicke in there once he got better. So the thing is this. Arthur Smith, I have no faith in him. I think he will make Dak a lot worse. I think he's going to. Now, to his credit, it's going to be interesting to see what you do with some serviceable quarterbacks, because Desmond Ridder was not that guy. So it's going to be interesting to see how you coach up Russell Wilson and Justin Fields in that offense that you have. Sort of, because this is the same offense that you had in San Francisco. Number one receiver, George Pickens. Tight end in Big O, Darnell Washington. From where? UGA. Ty Warren, Najee Harris. Sound familiar?
Mm-hmm.
That's the same thing you had in Atlanta. So let's see what you do now that you're in a more stable organization, in one of the more storied organizations like a Pittsburgh. Because if you can't do it there with all of these weapons that you have now, and you have serviceable quarterbacks now, then what can you do?
Yeah. But I do believe they're going to take care of CD, because at the end of the day, you got to pay him. And if you don't pay him, are you going to have to pay him even more, or are you going to let him walk out? Same thing with Micah. Dak, you've seen enough body of work with Dak to say this is as far as he can go. CD and Micah, on the other hand, they're young. They're around the same age. They're, what, 24, 25 years old?
Yeah.
Dak's 31 years old. Even though they're still relatively young, but at the same time, you've seen him from where he was as a rookie to where he is now. I think he's a good quarterback, at best top 10, but that's about it. Not much with Dak Prescott.